Welcome back to another episode of RS News. I'm your host, Charles Holmes, and our first news hit of the day, depending on how woke you are, will either ruin your childhood or make it even better. J.K. Rowling riled the people up. It was reported that on the Fantastic Beasts, The Crimes of Grindelwald Blu-ray, she had some spicy things to say about Dumbledore and Grindelwald. Quote, the relationship was incredibly intense. It was passionate. It was a love relationship. But as it happens in any relationship, gay or straight, or whatever label we want to put on it, one never knows really what the other person is feeling. You can't know. You can believe you know. Quote, so I'm less interested in the sexual side, though I believe there's a sexual dimension to this relationship, than I am in the sense of the emotions, blah, 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 blah. Basically, Dumbledore was getting his cheeks smashed, and people were like, you gotta stop doing this to us, JK. Wasn't in the books. You're not getting any woke points. For those of y'all who forgot, back in 2015, this is what JK had to say about Hermione. Canon, brown eyes, frizzy hair, and very clever. White skin was never specified. Rowling loves black Hermione, as do we all. Why didn't you just put it in the book? All right, we love hot Dumbledore. You wrote the last movie. We could have seen this sexy, steamy relationship on screen. You had the chance to put it up on screen, and you didn't. JK, I love you. Stop destroying your legacy, all right? RS News loves diversity. We don't love empty diversity. That was great, yo. I'm putting that on my reel. Yo, J. Cole, congrats. You're on the cover of GQ. And what did he decide to do? He decided to be brave, to be honest, to be bold, to have conviction, and to finally tell his fans enough is enough. He had something to say about the meme that was never funny. Quote, J. Cole is going platinum with no features. For those of you who are sane and don't understand what that means, J. Cole's last three albums all had no features and went platinum. What did he have to say about this meme? He said, quote, I was loving it. I was like, word up, it's funny as hell, but the second or third time I was like, all right, it's almost embarrassing now. Like, all right, man, y'all gonna make me put a feature on the album just so this can stop. And all I can say is, J. Cole, we're backing you. All of us who loved you, but were attacked for saying, guys, chill out. Having no features on your album is arbitrary at best and pompous at worst, are now vindicated. Put Roddy Ricch on that shit. Let's get a Vince Staples feature. Let's get, oh my God, Jackson Maine from A Star Is Born. Bradley Cooper on the next J. Cole album. Let's get it. Anyway, congrats J. Cole on your cover, on the new album. Love you. Our next feature, Juice WRLD is the biggest rock star on the planet. His debut is going to sell 165,000 copies in the first week. Is that the best first week sales for a rock act in 2019? I would know if I prepared for this show. Does this make Juice WRLD bigger probably than Maroon 5? Yes, in my book. Anyway, shout out to Juice WRLD for a number one album and this accomplishment. The last story of today is Amy Wang went to Apple. In the first media visit Apple has ever allowed to its under the radar music app studio, which makes GarageBand and Logic, Amy got to sit down with the people who are responsible for this wonderful technology that has changed everything about music production. The whole story is basically about how GarageBand made it very, very easy and very, very accessible for almost anybody to produce, which unfortunately or fortunately, GarageBand has potentially made music more homogenous, but various people such as Patrick Stump in the beginning of the article had this to say about the first time he used GarageBand. Quote, I opened it the first time and never looked back, he said about GarageBand. I just started recording without having to learn a new program, which was always one of the scariest things about music. Before that, he had been talking about how music programs before GarageBand were very, very technical, very, very glitchy. You could record something and a second later it could be gone. If you're doubting for how ubiquitous GarageBand has been, do you know a little song called Rihanna's hit Umbrella? Do you know another hit called Usher's Make Love in This Club? Both use sounds from GarageBand. So GarageBand has changed the world. And that's a world spinning. Now for the song of the day. It's getting warm outside. The barbecues are happening. We're throwing off our inhibitions. So I want to throw it to Coffee, who has Toast that's climbing up the charts in our hearts. It's a great summertime jam. Let's go. Blessings all for my life. Guys, thank you so much for watching this episode of RS News. I'm your host, Charles Holmes. If you're watching on YouTube, make sure to click in the description for links to all of the stories we referenced today. Make sure to click and subscribe, and I will see y'all tomorrow.